Alrighty, baseball fans, welcome to Minor League Baseball, the show. Today, we begin our first game of a three-game series between the Midland Rockhounds and the Northwest Arkansas Naturals. Well, today we will play here at beautiful Northwest Arkansas. Have our afternoon 4 o'clock game and partly cloudy skies for the day. Alright, let's get out your scorecards as we present today's starting lineups. First for the visiting Midland Rockhounds. Leading up and playing center field, Theodore Bach. Bach as center. Basil Lutz will be left field. He'll bat second for Midland. Lutz and left. Lewis Tillman will be our shortstop. He'll bat third for the Rockhound order. Tillman as short. Second baseman Steve Lombarazzi will bat fourth for the Rockhound order. Lombarazzi as second. Designated hitter is Renato Arturo. He'll be batting fifth for the Rockhounds. Arturo, the DH. Dustin Gornell will be our catcher. He'll have the catching duties for the Rockhounds. Gornell, catching. Billy Whitmore will be our third baseman. He'll bat seventh for Midland. Whitmore at third. First baseman Benito Lopez will bat eighth for the Rockhounds. Lopez at first. Right fielder Bo Fox round out the batting order for the Rockhounds this afternoon. Bach, Lutz, Tillman will be your lead on three. Lombarazzi, Arturo, and Garno will be your middle three. Whitmore, Lopez, and Fox round out the batting order for the Rockhounds this afternoon. And on the mound is Daniel Gossett. Gossett, today's Rockhounds pitcher. And now, here's the starting lineup for the Northwest Arkansas Naturals. Leading up and playing right field, Lewis Samuels. Samuels at right. Jimmy Arrero will be batting second for Northwest Arkansas. Arrero at second. Third baseman is Cody Ash. Ash at third. Designated hitter is Hunter Dozier. Dozier, the DH. Center fielder Cliff Widers. Widers as center. Left fielder James Ewise at left. The catching duties for Northwest Arkansas is Cam Gallagher. Gallagher at catching. First baseman is Connor Hernandez. He'll bat eighth for the Northwest Arkansas Naturals. Hernandez at first. Shortstop Thomas Reyes will round out the batting order for Northwest Arkansas. Samuels, Arrero, and Ash will be a lead on three. Dozier, Withers, and Ewas will be your middle three. Gallagher and Hernandez and Reyes round out the batting order for Northwest Arkansas. And on the mound is Brian De La Rosa. De La Rosa, today's Naturals pitcher. And now let's get ready for the starting first game of this three-game set. Northwest Arkansas versus the Midland Rockhounds. And now let's turn it over to Matt Vasgersian in the booth. Let's go, Matt.
Thank you. Daytime baseball here on MLB Network. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Northwest Arkansas Naturals and the Midland Rockhounds. Major League Baseball on MLB Network coming up right after this. Daniel Gossett, a hurler from South Carolina, will be the starting pitcher in this one. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, you don't see a lot of guys that have five pitches, right? Sometimes it's hard to master even two or three, but if you can master five like he has, he'll be in pretty good shape.
Now in the box, Luis Samuels. He will lead this one off today.
Off of the natural right
fielder. Here's the first pitch to him.
Samuel.
And afternoon baseball on MLB Network is underway. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Hit on the ground to short. Throw just in time as they get him by an eyelash. And with that, here's a look at the visitors' starting lineup. Vera, what's your take on this team today?
Maddie, I love the way this lineup's constructed. Talking to the manager before the game, he focused on the fact that they have a pass the baton mentality. Everything's flowing for this lineup. Chance to score a lot of runs.
Coming to the plate now, Jimmy Arroyo. He'll swing it from the left side right here. Pitch on the way. And that's in there for strike one. Our game time temperature pushing up close to 90 degrees, 89 degrees to be exact at first pitch. The 0-1 delivery. Almost a worm burner as he misses on a low fastball, ball one. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Slow grounder to first. And he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted.
Batting third, third baseman, Cody Ashe.
Now at the plate, Cody Ashe. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Looking at a tough pitch called a strike. There's a fastball that just misses, ball one. Now the 1-1 pitch. Is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
Only one strike away from throwing a very strong first inning to begin the ball game. He looks sharp.
High in the air down the right field line. Fox is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. So a relatively routine start for the top of the first here. So it's on to the bottom of inning number one, no score. Brian De La Rosa, a Pennsylvania-born lefty, gets the ball to start here. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have two or three of his four pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
So digging in now, Theodore Bach. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Center fielder. Theodore Bach.
First pitch of the at-bat. Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center. Uwasi, a range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first down. With a moment now, let's have a look at the home team starting lineup. Mark, daytime baseball at home. What do we need to know about these guys?
Well, Matty, you take a look at this lineup filled with young bloods. Just young guys, hungry, aggressive, trying to do damage and move traffic to both gaps. Line-to-line power up and down this lineup. Should be interesting to see if this pitcher uses their aggressiveness against them.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. lifted out towards straightaway center field. Whiters is after it. Two down.
Batting third.
At the plate, Lewis Tillman. First cuts for him here with the bases open and two away. First delivery to him on the way. Little tapper down the third baseline. On to first, and can you believe it? A three-pitch inning. And just like that, the side is retired. He played an inning. No score here on MLB Network. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Hunter Dozier. He'll get us started in the top of the second.
Designated hitter, Hunter Dozier.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. The fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Here's the 1-1. Looking at a fastball for a strike on the corner. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down.
Time for a look at the defensive alignment for the home team. And you talk about fitting a profile for a right fielder. Big surprise who brings the absolute bazooka to the game today. That is the right fielder. Don't look for anyone to test this guy.
Standing in, Cliff Whiters, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Takes a knee-high fastball. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. No score here as we play inning number two. And a slider misses here. Two balls and a strike.
Well, that's a good pitch, but you have to get a little bit closer to the plate than that. That's that big sweeping slider. If it was a little closer, you might get a swing.
And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1. The 3-1. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. Now the 3-2 pitch. And he looks at ball four now. So he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of the steal when he's on base.
Well, he battled to get it to a 3-2 count, but that pitch wasn't even close. Now he's got a man on with one out, so he's got to focus on trying to get the ground ball.
Ball one.
This is where he might need a mound visit, whether it be from the shortstop, his pitching coach, or the catcher. These last couple of pitches have certainly gotten away from him.
Runner. The 1-0 home. And there he goes towards second. Ground ball sent back up the middle. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him.
Hey, hit and run right there. I know the guy had to pull up on second base because the ball didn't get to the outfield, but you know what? You'll take the knock. First and second, regroup. Let's see what happens.
Into the box now, Cam Gallagher. He'll get to take his first cuts here. And that misses for ball one. Whiters on second. Uwasi at first, one gone. Zero. Swung on and missed. Outclassed by that fastball for a strike. Swing and a soft liner, but this is hauled in by the second baseman.
Batting eight. First base.
Stepping in, Connor Hernandez.
Hernandez.
Trying to hang a zero. Here's the pitch. Zero. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. A pause, and the 0-2. Now a swing and a chopper foul right at home plate. The next 0-2. And another foul ball. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one.
Not a real good pitch there, 0-2. Probably not what he was trying to do with that fastball. He was trying to miss probably up and away, and he threw that one down into the dirt on an 0-2 pitch. Very rarely are you going to get hitters to chase an 0-2 fastball.
Looking at a fastball to end the inning. Now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Steve Lombardozzi. He'll look to get something going here in this scoreless ball game. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Now this is chopped foul to home plate. It's 0-1. Swing and a little blooper to center. Reyes into shallow center, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first out.
All right, here's how the visitors are lining up today. And one of the main backbones for them out on the field today is the guy behind the dish. He controls the entire flow of the game, manipulates a pitch and staff, gets them through the game, and not only that, completely shuts down a running game.
First offering on its way. And he's in front of a tight little slider that time. The windup and the 0-1. Very weakly on the ground. Foul ball, strike two. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Here's a little chopper up the middle. Reyes takes it in. And they will get, no, he's in there, a very close play at first.
Hey, that's great hustle right there out of the box. Not everybody's getting it right out of the chute from step one, but I have to ask you, Dan, how frustrating executing a pitch and there's an infield knock.
It is, D-Roy, and you can read that right off the bat as a pitcher. You can read the angle. You know that that ball is going to be hit on the ground, and you're thinking deep down inside, okay, there's a quick out, and it just wasn't meant to be.
And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. Bottom of the second here with no score. The 1-2 is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Well, I'm glad we get another look at that beauty of a pitch right there. You can't spot a sinker in a better location, because even if you do get the bat on the ball, there's not a whole lot you can do with that. Textbook sinker.
In now, Billy Whitmore lifted the other way out to left center. Whiters giving chase. He's not going to have a play on it, and this might bring home the runner from first. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
Just goes to show, if you're going to throw that two-seam fastball away, which I don't think is the best pitch anyway, you better start that thing out of the zone and let it work its way back to the corner. With this one, it started out in the corner, so it leaked back right over the heart of the plate and got whacked.
Standing in now, Benito Lopez. And now here's a ball hit pretty well out toward right center field. Samuels is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. Now at the play, Tomas Reyes. And he'll start out their half of the third, top of the order to follow. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. The 1-0. Line drive to left. Lutz is right there as he puts it away. No problem for the first out.
Good contact to start out the inning. Thought he might be on base with some sort of a hit, but it hung up there too long. Just unlucky that time.
Stepping in now, Luis Samuels. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Two balls and no strikes.
That's a good approach when you're facing a young arm you might not be too familiar with. Take a look at a few and see what he's got. Now he's got himself ahead in the count.
And he'll find a way to dodge the shrapnel out there to make the play for route number two.
Batter number 24, second baseman, Jimmy
digging in for his second at-bat, Jimmy Arroyo. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time. Now a fastball a bit too low here. It's ball one.
Stay on the attack if you're the pitcher right here. You know who's lurking, 3-4-5, and you'd love to see that number three hole hitter lead that next inning off.
Lifted down the line and left, and no one will track it down. Bouncer to the left side. Whitmore right there. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Pretty painless half of the inning, all told. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three, and we are tied 0-0. Digging in now, Bo Fox.
Leading off on the Rockhound. Right fielder, Bo Fox.
First delivery to him on the way. A swing and a miss at a ball down.
Hey, that was a nasty pitch right there. It's the depth of his sinker. Sometimes it's a matter of whether or not it's moving east-west, but that one right there had such good downward action. Great pitch.
And that's out number one.
Now batting, center fielder, Theodore Bach.
Ready for another chance, Theodore Bach. First pitch of the at-bat. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Whiters will range to his left and put it away. Two down.
Now batting.
Stepping up to the plate, Basil Lutz. 0 for 1 here in the early going. Here comes the first pitch. Weak grounder back to the mound. Offline throw, but a good job of getting back to the bag as the side is retired. So they go down without a whimper here. On now to the top of inning number four. And we are tied 0-0. Here's Cody Ashe. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners on to get him in, but that hasn't been the case.
That's his first base hit, making 1 for 2 now. So it's a base knock to lead off their half of the fourth.
Dan, are you kidding me right there? I mean, that had to whistle past this guy's ear. That was a scary moment.
Dero, they call that the old chuck and duck, right? That was really close, and that's one of the things that most pitchers fear, that line drive that zips right by your head. Wow, that was awful close.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Takes a look down at the knees for a strike.
Hey, this guy has been locating his fastball all game to perfection. Talking to a number of big league pitchers over the years, they'll tell you a well-executed fastball with good location is still the best pitch in the game.
Both teams with just two hits apiece thus far. Again, he sends it out of play.
Batter's going to have to find a way to regroup right there. That caught too much of the plate. He knew it. He missed it. He might not get another opportunity to put the ball in play.
In the dirt, and now let's see. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch. Here now the 2-2 is laid off and the count runs full.
Wow, this is a pretty good at bat right here. From down in the count 0-2 to work the count back to 3-2. And he's seen a lot of pitches too.
And a swing and a miss there on a late breaking slider as he set down on strikes for the second time this afternoon. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Cliff Whiters. He drew a walk his first time up. First offering on its way. Hit out towards second. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him.
Now back.
Now at the plate, James Uwase.
James Uwase.
First pitch coming. Here it is. There's a knee-high pitch that catches the zone.
First and third, you know he's going to do everything he can on the mound to roll up a double play ball. On the other side, he's got to be looking for a mistake up in the zone that he can drive in the air and pick up a sac fly at the very least.
Into the corner and slicing foul. And this ball's pretty well struck high and deep to left field. And that nearly would have got him on the board. Instead, it's a long foul ball. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Now a ball line softly down the left field line, but this is a foul ball. Misses ball two. The 2-2. And this one's tapped foul at home plate.
Hey, he's got four foul balls in this AB right here. He's really making his pitcher grind for everything.
And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
Lombardozzi takes charge out there, and he stays with it for the second out.
Now batting, catcher.
Striding in once again, Cam Gallagher. Two men on, two away here in the fourth. First pitch of the at-bat. There's a strike.
This guy's cruising along, pitching well as we enter the middle innings of this one. Less than 60% of his first pitches have been for strikes. If he could clean that up a little bit, he could really...
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. Digging in to try it again, Lewis Tillman.
Leading off the fourth inning, the shortstop, Lewis Tillman.
Ready with the first pitch, here it comes. And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. This one's down to third. Ashy's up with it. And there's one away.
Now batting, second baseman, Steve Lombardozzi.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Steve Lombardozzi. He's 0-for-1 thus far. First pitch on its way. Swing and a little tapper. It's foul, strike one. Wind up and the 0-1. Heading out towards shallow right. Samuels moves over, makes the play, and there are two gone now.
Now batting, designated hitter, Reynaldo Arturo.
To the plate now is the designated hitter, Reynaldo Arturo. Here's the first pitch to him. Lined hard to center field. And now a diving effort, but this is off the center fielder's glove. the relay, and he is in there.
Yeah, this one was starting to look like it was going to be one of those 1-2-3 easy innings, but now all of a sudden, they have the go-ahead run standing out there at second base after the two-out double. Big moment here.
And here now is Dustin Garneau, and it's fouled away. Looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat. The 0-1. And boy, big problems here to start this at-bat. It's 0-2 now.
After that swing, you just got to reset yourself. You still have a strike to work with, and you can't be thinking about how silly you just looked on that last pitch.
Here's the 0-2. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Danger averted following the two-out double. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. In now, Connor Hernandez. He'll start things out here in a tie ball game.
First baseman, Connor.
And the first pitch of the inning here misses down and in for a ball. It's 1-0. The 1-0 home is taken for ball two.
That was a non-competitive pitch right there, and he finds himself behind 2-0 in this situation. He's going to have to locate something down in the zone to get himself back in this count.
And there's the first strike, 2-1. Now the 2-1 is laid off of for ball number three.
If you're ever going to see a position player go to the mound, it's going to be in a situation like this. Get him to relax a little bit, focus on his mechanics, and get that fastball back in the zone. Can't allow this guy to lead off walk.
The 3-1. And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across yet, so maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little bit.
Here's the first pitch to him. Now a bunt attempt here, and they'll just tag him out along the first base line.
Sacrifice was in order right there as he gets the bunt down right there, and sometimes it's easier to just tag him instead of making that throw to first base.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Comes right after him with a fastball for a strike. Hernandez, the runner at second with one away. Is a swing and a high pop-up. Tillman is there, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning.
The batter number 20.
Digging in once again, Jimmy Arroyo, runner in scoring position with two gone. Hoping to keep it tied, here it comes. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Fastball in there for a strike. 92 on the radar gun that time. Ground ball right side. Lombardozzi in the hole. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him.
Now batting.
Here's Cody Ashe. A fly out and a single for him so far. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner. Oh, and two, here it comes. hit sharply on the ground. And that is through into center field, a base hit. The run comes across to score, and they jump ahead 1-0.
Boy, it's been tough to score in this one so far through the fifth inning, but that RBI base hit right there is a nice breakthrough.
Yeah, it's been a great pitcher's duel up until this point. They've been executing on the bump without question, but that RBI knock right there might set the tone for the later innings.
And that brings in Hunter Dozier, as he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch.
No, that's a ball.
And a fastball just misses. It's 1-1. The 1-1 pitch. There's a fastball right over the inside corner.
All right, let's take a step back right here. He's down 1-2, three fastballs in a row. There is no way he's throwing him a fourth.
The 1-2. In the dirt and blocked behind the plate. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. Oh, that hit him. Let's hope he's okay. The runner does score from third, and let's hope he's going to be all right.
The batter, center fielder, Cliff Whiters.
Ready once again, Cliff Whiters. He's set, now the pitch. Weak chopper up the line. That winds up foul. Sent on the ground out to second. He'll get to this one deep in the hole. Throw on to first, and a good job of working out of that one with just limited damage as the inning is over. So two runs on three hits, no errors, and two men left stranded. Last half of the fifth coming up. Northwest Arkansas out in front, 2-0. Riding into the box, Billy Whitmore. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
Got him out on his front foot. It's 0-2. Another 0-2. Slow bouncer to the right side, but that one rolls foul. Grounded to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
Now batting, first baseman, Benito Lopez.
Stepping into the box, Benito Lopez. He flew out in his last at-bat. Here's the first pitch to him. Hit on the ground out to short. Oh, what a stop on the slide. What a way to get it out. Two gone now. That was exceptional.
Now batting, right fielder, Bo Fox.
Into the box now, Bo Fox. First pitch coming. Here it is. Now a ball lined toward the alley in left center. And that'll split the gap as it should be extra bases. And he is in to second with a two-out double. Finally, a little something for them to get excited about.
Yeah, a rally can begin with a single swing of the bat, and this might be their chance right here. They've struggled to produce a lot of runs, but there he is at second base. A shot to the outfield scores him. Then who knows what kind of roll they could get on. Got to take it one good at-bat at a time.
Into the box now, Theodore Bach. And here's a ball in the air now, carrying a bit out toward right center. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Stepping in and ready for another shot, James Uwasi. First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0. called strike at the knees. Evens the count at 1-1. A ball and two strikes now.
1-2.
The 1-2. Little dribbler down the line, but it gets fouled. Another 1-2. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Bach on the move. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out.
The catcher, number 36.
Ready for another chance? Cam Gallagher. He's lined out and flied out in two plate appearances.
No.
And that misses ball one. Bases are empty, one man out. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. And that misses 2-1. And he misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1. Into his motion. Here comes the 3-1. There's ball four.
Now batting, first baseman.
Ready for another shot now. Connor Fernandez. First delivery to him on the way. Takes a fastball on the inside corner. One, here it comes. Swing and a line drive. Foul. And a fastball. Flew it right by him, and there are two down. Didn't mess around much in that at-bat, Dan.
No, that was pretty impressive, Matt. I really like a pitcher that trusts and works off his fastball. Right there, he decided he didn't need to use anything else. Three straight heaters, and go grab some bench.
In now, Tomas Reyes. He'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He laid down a sacrifice bunt in his last trip. A swing and a miss just out in front of that fastball. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. This is lined to left, and that's in there. Base hit.
I appreciate the moxie right there, but three fastballs at this level usually turns into a knock.
Samuels.
Standing in now, Luis Samuels. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. Now the 1-0. Grounded to short. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Riding in once again, Basil Lutz. He'll start the inning, and we're back to the top of the order, but they haven't looked too dangerous in this one yet, right, guys?
Well, none of them have any hits yet, so you're right on the money. They've done a great job.
One sack as that ball is into the gap in right center. Should be good for at least two bases. And he is into second base with a leadoff double.
As we take another look here, you can see it's a two-seam fastball. Running away from him at the plate. So he does this smart thing, not trying to pull it or just rolling over it, just goes with it and has enough juice on it to drive it for a double.
Into the box, Lewis Tillman. And he'll quickly send a line drive to center field. And that's in there, base hit. And they'll get it in quickly. It's first and third now with nobody out.
Hey, this has the makings of being a pretty big inning, D-Roll. Leadoff double, now a base hit, and all of a sudden we're looking at first and third.
Yeah, sometimes you wake up and just get smacked in the mouth right here. He's going to have to start executing pitches. He cannot leave a ball over the heart of the plate right here. He's going to have damage on his hands.
Into the box now, Steve Lombardozzi. Pitch out, nothing doing. Now the 1-0. And this is on the ground to short. Could be two. One there on the first, and it's a double play, though that first run of the ball game is across the score.
It certainly looked like they might have had a big inning cooking there with first and third and no outs, but the double play kind of kills it. They did get the run in, but the batter doesn't get credit for an RBI.
Stepping in now, Ronaldo Arturo. As he'll get caught chasing a bad one there, it's strike one. Two hits and two trips for him thus far. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Chopped weakly to the left. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. And a good effort as he's able to stick with it and get the third out of the inning. So it's one run on two base hits, no errors, and no one left on base. We're through six full. The Naturals lead it 2-1. Back here on MLB Network. It's on to the seventh inning now, but before the inning gets started, let's fill you in on what you may have missed. It's our game summary to this point. Digging in once again, Jimmy Arroyo. He'll start the seventh, and Dan, as a former pitcher yourself, you must be enjoying this. Lots of good pitching and defense today.
Oh, that's one of the keys. We're seeing a lot of strikes. We're seeing a lot of swings. We're seeing some great plays on defense. This has been a snappy one up to this point.
Down and away, ball one. The 1-1 home is in there for strike number two. The 1-2. Hit hard to third. To his right, Whitmore. Throw in the dirt, but a good job of staying with it that time as he's retired.
Now batting. Third baseman, Cody.
Ready once again, Cody Ashe. It was an RBI single for him in his last plate appearance. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Line drive to center field. Bach is there now, and he has it. Two gone.
Now batting, designated hitter, Hunter Dozier.
And that brings in Hunter Dozier. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. First offering on its way. Fastball, and he swings through it to fall behind. The windup and the 0-1. Swing and a miss just behind a lively fastball.
Little hesitation right there by the batter. It was great execution by the pitcher down and away. But that looked like a late swing. Could have been sitting on something else.
To 1-2 now. Got him! And he goes down on strikes for the third time.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the traditional seventh inning stretch.
And here now is Dustin Garneau. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
Line toward the gap in left center, and that'll be a base hit. So right away, the possible tying run is aboard to start the bottom of the seventh.
You can't ask for anything more than getting a leadoff man on right there. It brings the go-ahead run to the plate. He's in position to do some damage. It'll be interesting to see how the manager plays this one.
Skipper's out of the third base dugout on his way toward the mound, and it would appear he's seen enough of his starter this afternoon. So he'll depart with the lead and a chance to be the winner, but he is responsible for the tying run at first.
Mark Steele.
Billy Whitmore will be the first to stand in against the new pitcher, as he'll do so with the runner at first and nobody out. Here comes the first pitch. High in the air into shallow left center. Calling for it, Uwasi. One down.
Now back.
Digging in to try it again, Benito Lopez. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. From the stretch, a little bouncer was foul for strike one. The 0-1 on its way. Oh, on the ground is short. Could this be two? To second for one, but they won't get two as he beats the relay to first. Digging in and looking for more, Bo Fox. One for two with a double on his line thus far. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Hit hard to the right, but foul. Set to deliver the 0-1. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Lopez leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Hit on the ground to short. Played on the backhand. And a close play at first, but he's called out, and the side is retired. Digging in, Cliff Whiters. He'll start things out for us here in inning number eight. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. And a fastball that's about off the radar screen there. It's 2-0.
Back-to-back pitches, they've gone away. Do you tell yourself as a hitter he wants to come in right here? I don't think so. I think he's trying to find that outside corner and adjust accordingly.
3-0 to him now. And he'll just make him throw one over here. 3-1.
Four pitches, all takes. He's showing a lot of patience here.
And I like that from a guy like him, Eddie. He can do a lot of damage on the base pass with his legs, so there's no reason for him to get overly aggressive if he's not getting anything to handle.
Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. Takes a fastball on the inside corner.
Hey, excellent job to get yourself back in this count after throwing three consecutive balls. You got a chance to get an out right here.
Swing and a liner. Foul. And the payoff pitch. Hit on the ground out to short. Tillman is up with it. And safe, says the first base umpire, as the throw was too late.
So frustrating, Hero. You make a good pitch, and you get these guys that can run around, and they're fast. You think you have an out, and all of a sudden it turns into an infield single.
Yeah, this is definitely part of his game, the ground attack, Dan. He's a speedster. He's going to get a ton of infield singles, and he knows how frustrated that pitcher is.
1-1 the count now. Hits are even at 7 apiece. Takes a knee-high fastball. The 1-2. Swing and a little blooper to center. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Beggars can't be choosers right there. We love those long darts. Doesn't matter how they come. Jammed off the end of the bat. Doesn't matter.
Now at the plate, Cam Gallagher. And it seems like maybe they're starting to get to the guy on the mound a bit now.
Yeah, and that could be a sign that he's starting to wear down a little bit, Matt. The first thing to go when you're getting tired is usually your command. So even if you're throwing strikes, they might be a little bit more hittable than they were earlier in the game.
All right, something to keep an eye on if he remains in the game much longer.
Now batting, first baseman, Connor Hernandez.
Stepping up now, Connor Hernandez. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. To the right side and through a base hit. Wassy is on his way home. He will score. As they extend the lead a bit, it's now a 3-1 game.
Boy, that's a big RBI right there to give this team a two-run cushion going into the late innings. And it always makes it easier on the opposing pitcher to know they have a two-run lead.
Yeah, Leo Mazzoni always used to say, old pitching coach for the Atlanta Braves, solos won't kill us, guys. And he's absolutely right. You give yourself a two-run lead, a solo homer is not gonna do too much damage.
Fastball called for strike two.
Don't just assume as a hitter right here he won't triple up. He's got you down 0-2, and he might really want to get inside your head if he throws the same pitch again.
One ball and two strikes to count.
Two and two.
I'm seeing all the signs of fatigue right now. This is when you really have to bear down mentally as a pitcher.
Gallagher at second. Hernandez is over at first with one away. Outside and a full count, 3-2.
One of the things you want to do with a starter, get that pitch count up. Here's another productive at-bat as this count now gets to 3-2.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch-out. Tomas Reyes goes down for out number two in the top half.
Anytime a pitcher locates a fastball on the inside corner, it's going to be a tough pitch to hit. That one was spot on, and he had no answer for it.
In there, strike one. Struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. And he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
In today's game, if you're not disciplined for striking out, why would you change your approach with two strikes right here? Expect this guy to try and drive the baseball right here.
Count is 1-2 now. And tough fastball to lay off on 1-2, but he did, and it's 2-2 now. Already 24 pitches to this point in the inning. Into center field, and that's going to get down for a base hit. Gallagher rounds third and is digging for the plate. He'll score easily as they push their lead to 3 now.
Hey, Dero, that's a big RBI right there to stretch this lead to 3. Takes a lot of pressure off your pitcher going into the bottom part of the inning.
Yeah, Dan, no doubt. As an offense, all you're trying to do is put your pitchers in positions to be successful. Giving them that 3-run cushion has to make you feel good.
In now, Jimmy Arroyo hit down the line at first. Scooped up, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. So it's 2 runs on 4 base hits. No errors and a couple of men left on. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the 8th coming up. Northwest Arkansas out in front, 4-1. Tony Siegel is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the 8th.
Number 33, Tony Siegel.
Leading off the inning, Theodore Bach. And they'll need him to get something going here.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
A bouncer to the left side. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
I know it wasn't pretty right there, Dan, but that has to frustrate the pitcher. Leadoff guy, anytime he gets on, usually creates a problem.
Hey, you know what, Dero? It's especially tough when you get as late in the game as we are right now. Anytime you get that leadoff guy on and have that pitcher start pitching out of the stretch, it always puts more stress on that pitcher pitching out of the stretch.
Lifted in the air toward the line and right, but this is going to wind up a foul ball.
You can't allow this offense to get going right here. Leadoff man on doesn't kill us. Let's try and roll a double play right here. Let's execute a good pitch down and away. See if we can get a ground ball and rely on your defense a little bit.
Comes set and the 0-1. Hit back up the middle. Oh, a reaching fly as he knocks it down. And the throw will be too late as he can't recover in time.
Nice effort by the shortstop right there. Kept it in front of him. That's all he could do right there, Dan.
You know, Gio, in a spot like that, that's an infield single. That's a tough play. Just to knock that ball down was a pretty good job. But any way you look at it, that should be scored a base hit, and I'm sure it was.
Now at the plate, Lewis Tillman. And, Dan, what's the plan of attack here for the guy on the mound?
Well, I think they have to go right after him. He's pretty unlikely to take the deep. But if you allow him to get on base, the chances of him scoring and tying this game become a lot greater.
Here comes the first pitch. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Samuels sprinting after it. And that's the first out of the inning. Digging in the switch hitter, Steve Lombardozzi. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Now a swing and a ball pulled softly out toward right. And that's a fair ball as this one will get down the line. The runner scores from second.
Oh, wow.
You know, that's a nice knock right there, but I want to take a look at the base runner. He got a nice secondary lead. He read that it was a soft liner and it was going to fall, and he's able to steal his teammate an RBI.
Boy, amen about that, D-Roll. One of the things I think in base running is all about instincts, and that was a terrific read. He took a chance right off the bat that that ball was going to break in and fall in, and a good job, and he picks up an RBI for his teammate.
He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. One pitch on its way. Left side. A dive, and he knocks it down. And they'll be left with no play, as that's going to load the bases now on what should be ruled an infield single.
Dustin Garneau.
So stepping in, Dustin Garneau, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. He's set, and the pitch. Just a bit jumpy that time. Swung on and missed. Now some action out in the bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander begin throwing. On the ground, left side. That's a base hit. And the runner from third crosses the plate. And they'll hold that runner at third, so everyone moves up, and they remain loaded here with still only one gone.
Billy.
Boy, that's a tough one right there if you're a pitcher, D-Ro. You think you make a decent pitch, ball hit to the hole right through there. You're hoping it can get knocked down. Instead, base hit, run batted in.
Yeah, and as the batter right there, you're taking off your batting gloves, giving dabs to the first baseman. Glad that that found the hole right there. Ribeye steak, chocolate.
Edwin Valenzuela was called upon to pitch, really needing that double play ball. Bases are loaded here with only one man out. Standing in now, Billy Whitmore, as he'll take a look at ball one. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. The 1-0. Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but a foul ball, 1-1. The 1-1. Hit out toward second. Fielded cleanly. And the throw to first will take care of him, but it comes at a cost as the tying run is in to score.
I like that he didn't try to do too much there. All he needed was a ground ball to tie this thing up, and that's exactly what he does. That's great situational hitting.
So striding forward now, Benito Lopez. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind it, because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
Mm-hmm. First pitch of the at-bat to short. And the throw to first is in time, but the damage has been done as the side is retired. So they strike for three runs on five hits, no errors, and a couple of men left on. Ninth inning coming up, and we are tied 4-4. Stepping into the box, Cody Ashe. And his guys need him to get things started here in the top half of the ninth.
Cody Ashe.
Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a called strike. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. A fastball that just misses inside. Now the 1-1 pitch. And he gives this a pretty good ride that time, but that's going to be up amongst the crowd, a foul ball. And a swing and a miss on the fastball, and there's the first out here in the ninth.
That's a pretty unique pitch sequence, guys. Usually pitching is all about mixing pitches and location, but he threw that all out the window to get that strikeout. He offered the same pitch three times in a row, so I guess he sort of used that reverse psychology to outthink his opponent.
Into the box, Hunter Dozier. And a swing from him yields a foul pop out of play to the right. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. The windup and the 0-1. And 1-1 as this one's in on the hand. Fastball called strike. 1-2. One out, nobody on. 2-2 to Hunter Dozier.
Wow, that was a close pitch on 1-2. The count's now on 2-2, but boy, that one very easily could have been called strike three. Really close pitch.
Ready on 2 balls and 2 strikes. Here it comes. 2-2 pitch just missed.
Well, the 1-2 pitch didn't go his way, and now a miss there on 2-2. You know he doesn't want this at bat to get away from him, so I think we're going to see a challenge pitch on a full count.
Hit on the ground out to short. Throw gets him, 2 down.
Now batting, the center fielder, Cliff Whiters.
Settling in now, Cliff Whiters. First delivery to him on the way. Laid off as it caught the inside corner. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And a fastball just below the knees, ball one. Now the 1-1 pitch. Grounded up the first baseline. To his left, Lopez. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Nothing across here this half. 9-1-2 scheduled to lead off the bottom of the ninth. And we are tied 4-4. Striding into the box, Bo Fox. He'll be the one to get us going here in the bottom of inning number 9.
Fielder, Bo Fox.
First pitch on its way. That ball's headed for the gap in left center. He's got a base hit, possibly more. The relay. And it's in time. He's out at second as a good relay gets him.
Well, he clearly thought he had a shot at two on the hit, but they did a nice job in the outfield of getting it in quick to cut him down.
Into the box now, Theodore Bach, as he grounds one briskly to short. And that's the second out.
Now batting, left fielder, Basil Lutz.
Standing in, Basil Lutz. He's 2-for-4 in the ballgame. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And a feeble swing that time. It's 0-1.
Ugly swing right there. That pitch wasn't even close, and he offered at it. I'm not sure right now. If I'm the pitcher, you could probably throw anything you want up there, and this guy's going to swing at it.
Grounder down the line at third. And this is down for extra bases. And there's your winning run moving into scoring position. And a good job to get to it quickly and get it back in. That'll hold him to a two-out single.
Hey, that's a nice piece of hitting right there. Two-out base knock to put the winning run on base. Let's see if someone can catch a gap and end this.
In now, Lewis Tillman. Swinging a ball pulled hard down the line in left. And he might have done it. Can they score that runner from first? The relay throw. And he'll try to get back now, but it's not going to work. The throw hangs him out to dry, and that'll end the inning. So they can't get that winning run home, and that means free baseball here this afternoon. 10th inning coming up, and we are tied 4-4. So coming to the plate, James Uwase. And I don't know about you guys, but I'm a bit surprised to see the bullpen inactive right now.
Yeah, I'm with you, Matt. Even though he's pitching okay, I do think you have to look at what he's given you and realize he's probably approaching the end of his rope pretty soon. Last thing you want is for things to start to unravel and not have a guy ready that you can turn to.
Fastball got him to swing through it. It's 1-1. And it's 1-2.
One ball, two strikes.
The 1-2. Flips the inside corner for strike three.
The catcher, number 36. Cam
digging in, Gallagher. Cam Gallagher. He reached on a fielder's choice previously. In there for strike one. Here's the 0-1. Hit down the third baseline. But that'll get foul. It's 0-2 now. Looking to put him away. Here's the 0-2. Hit down the line at first. But this will wind up foul. Still 0-2. Bases are empty. One man out. Sent on the ground out to second. Lombardozzi is there. Throw in time at first for out number two.
Now batting, the first baseman, Connor Hernandez.
Stepping into the box, Connor Hernandez. He singled his last time up. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1.
No ball, one strike.
A bouncer up the middle. And he'll throw against his body to first. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Nothing doing here this half. So one will win it here as we go to the bottom of inning number 10. And we are tied 4-4. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Steve Lombardozzi. He came through with an RBI single in his last at-bat. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Lifted the other way out to left center. Whiters on the move. He's there and records the first out.
Now batting.
To the plate now is the designated hitter, Rinaldo Arturo. He'll look to keep it going. 3-for-4 so far in the ballgame. First offering on its way. Out in front here is this one scorched foul to the left. This is line to left. And a dive in left, but he can't get it. It'll get by him toward the wall. He's around second now, and they still haven't gotten to this thing. And he will make it all the way to third now as that mistake proves a costly one indeed.
And that's the chance you take when you lay out for a ball like that. You make the play, and you're a hero in the highlight shows. You miss it, and you're picking yourself up and chasing after it.
One, two, one.
And here now is Dustin Garneau. This is lined into left field, and it's going to fall for a base hit. And they're going to walk off here with a 5-4 win.
Well, the way things unfolded, you kind of had a sense that this thing was going to end in dramatic fashion, and that's exactly what happened. A walk-off for the win? Wow.
Several good offensive performances in this one, but none better than the one turned in by the guy you see right there. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, Matty, he definitely led the way. You'll see there, he turned in a four-hit performance, and that definitely keyed his guys to victory.
Run finish today, 5-4 the final score. The Midland Rockhounds crossed the plate three times in the eighth, helping propel them to the win. Daniel Gossett pitches well enough to get the W, so that'll just about do it. For my partners Mark DeRosa and Dan Plezak, this is Matt Vaskersian. You've been watching a presentation of MLB Network. So long, everybody.
Well, this was a exciting game, everybody. This was one of the best games I have ever seen. First, in the first inning, through the fourth, it was nothing. Arkansas scores two, top of the fifth, and the Rockhounds nothing. So anyway, top of the sixth was nothing. The Rockhounds scored, bottom of the first, and top of the seventh, through the bottom of the seventh, no score. Northwest Arkansas gets two more as it's four. And at the bottom of the eighth, the Rockhounds go for three, tying up the game 4-4. At the bottom of the tenth, that was the last run of the game. The Rockhounds win it. And most likely, guys, best game ever. It was a solid 5-star game. Well, tomorrow is our second game of this 3-game series. And most likely, guys, it is something to be smiling about. The Rockhounds come back, and most likely, this was a 5-4 ball game. Well, this will just about do it for Rockhounds Baseball this afternoon. We'll see y'all again tomorrow afternoon for an all-new Rockhounds Baseball with Northwest Arkansas. So, from my friends in the booth here, Dan Plezak and Matt Vaskersian, this has been a presentation of Minor League Baseball, the show. And don't forget to tune in for more baseball tomorrow. So long, everybody. Got to make it to first. It feels like every second's stolen.